Hi Virgos, welcome to Mirakida Tribe. My name is Ayushi. This is going to be for your November 2018. This is for Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising. So guys, use your own intuition while listening to these messages. So apply to your situation as it may suit, and all the messages may not resonate with you. So kindly make sure that you do not force the messages in your situation. So let's see what is coming up for Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising for the month of November 2018. Okay, so Virgo, this is the first card which is coming out, which is a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn card. This is Daughter of Pentacles, someone who is on a standstill. This person is not moving, not making any moves. They are still trying to understand how to take the next step. They are planning, and they are in a planning stage basically. So they are very, after they have planned, they will move forward with their plan. And most of their effort is directed towards planning, like the best plan. This person figure out the best plan, and when they are almost certain about everything that they are going to do, how they are going to do, what kind of situation they are going to be facing, once they are sure about all those things, they start moving. So this is probably you or someone around you who is taking their own sweet time. And then bottom of the deck is Three of Cups. So there is probably some celebration, like marriage, engagement or something of that nature. It can be also a just friendly gathering that you are attending, and maybe in this gathering you are just observing your friends and just trying to assess who is doing what, and how far they have come or how far you have come in comparison to them. I do not encourage comparison because it's of no use, but if you are doing that, I think you are taking inspiration, and you are probably also sharing your plans with your friends. So you are probably saying that this is what I plan to do and stuff like that. What are the messages coming up for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising? November 2018. This is going to be a 10 card Celtic cross. What are the messages coming up for Virgos 2018 November? Okay. The High Priestess. Some of you were dealing with a Pisces person, or are dealing with a Pisces person, or a Cancer person, Sun, Moon, Rising, and the bottom of the deck right now is the Ace of Swords. It can be a Aquarius, Libra, Gemini as well. So someone is speaking their truth. This person is someone who knows a lot, but they do not speak. They just know, and they keep it to keep the information to themselves until and unless they are asked to speak. So this person is quite knowledgeable and all knowing. They know stuff and they can sense and intuit things, very perceptive basically. And this is the card which is coming up. So someone is speaking their truth, or someone is very clear with their intuition. They are right now, you can be also very, very intuitive and perceptive. So you might be clearing things out in your life, speaking how you're feeling and stuff like that. You're also making certain decisions. You are coming to one concrete decision, like I said, and you are going to communicate your ideas with deep inner knowing. Some of you are on a spiritual journey or a mysterious, you may find yourself in a very mysterious spot. One last shuffle for Virgo. So definitely what's important for you right now is looking for stability, looking for home, looking for commitment, looking for looking for comfort in a very cozy spot. So you want a corner where you can unfold, unwind and relax. You're thinking about something of that nature and you want to take something that you are already building, like a relationship or a something like a business. You are taking it one step further. Now the other card that you have is the Magician. So this is a Aries card. So I'm getting that maybe right now you are feeling that you don't have enough resources to take one step further or move one step ahead. You are probably facing financial, finances are probably not, finances is basically one of the problem that you're facing, finances, and you're also looking away from clarity. Like you feel that you don't have any clarity and you don't have any you are far away from the truth. That is what you're feeling, and you're very upset in a way that things are not inspiring you, or you are not able to look forward because you feel that there is nothing in the future, and that's what you're feeling. What's root of this reading is the Nine of Cups. So you have a lot of dreams, lot of desires, lot of expectations, lot of hopes, and some of them are also coming true, but there is a but. Like some things are coming true to fruition, but you may not fully be fully satisfied. You might be feeling that you are getting addicted to something, some things that you should not be, like a comfortable lifestyle. So you are probably getting way too comfortable, or you are just ignoring something. In past you have the Ace of Swords. So there was some clarity, some truth was spoken, something was cut out from your life in the past, and there was an idea that you wanted to pursue probably in the past, and you are still hanging on to that idea and feeling like that. And what's on your mind is the High Priestess. So I already shuffled and still these two cards are coming out, so that's weird. On your mind, High Priestess, so there is some mystery that you are exploring definitely, or you're dealing with a Piscean person. I don't know what else to say. Like I'm getting that you want to explore some mystery, like there is something mysterious going on and you want to get to the bottom of it. I think it's a major arcana, so you don't really have any control over this mystery. This mystery will unfold when it when it is supposed to unfold. You cannot rush into it, and just get comfortable with the mystery itself is what I'm getting here. In future, I'm getting Father of Wands. So Father of Wands is someone who is very determined, goal oriented, very charismatic. This person is actively pursuing their dreams and desires. They are not laid back, they are not chilling. They have achieved a lot and they are confident in what they have achieved, and they cannot be they are super confident. They cannot be sidelined or they cannot be ignored. They make their presence felt. So maybe you want to be this person, or you are meeting someone like this. This is your card. This is how you are coming up in your reading, which is Hangman, which is again a Piscean card. So there is a lot of emphasis in your reading for the opposite zodiac sign. So Virgo's opposite is Pisces. So maybe you are getting a lot of, you need to learn a lot of Piscean traits basically, is what I'm feeling here. Like for example, Pisceans are very good with navigating through emotions and through dealing with the unknown. They are very adaptable. They find it very easy to adapt, and they are very very spiritually guided and motivated. So maybe there is some spiritual awakening that is going on here, because the Hangman is someone who is looking at a situation from a perspective which is new to them. So they are trying to understand the scenario from a better or a newer perspective. Like they are trying to question their belief system. They are trying to understand something that they are dealing with from a different outlook. This is a very difficult position to be in since your belief system is getting shook up basically. So you might need a lot of questioning, like you need to ask the right questions is what I'm getting here. And then the Virgo card coming up as your outside influence. So someone outside you is almost like a Virgo. So I'm also getting that you are in a retreat, or someone that you are dealing with is in a retreat, or both of you are retreating. Like this person is retreating and you are also retreating, because look at this. Both these cards are about isolation. The Hermit and the Hangman, and one is the Piscean card, one is the Virgo card. So the Hermit is someone who is looking for answers within. They are being their own light and their own guide, and they are trying to look for answers within. Basically they are meditating and meditating on their question or their situation. This person doesn't want to come out of their shell right now, and this is someone probably that you are dealing with, because they feel that their cocoon is safe. Wherever they are hiding, they feel it's safe. So that is what you are going to do as well. Here I am feeling that you are also retreating in a dark room basically, and you are trying to wait. You are waiting basically. Your hopes and fears is the Ten of Cups. So you hope that things will normalize and you will move from Nine of Cups to Ten of Cups. That's what I was feeling. Right now you might be feeling very fulfilled, but there is a but. And I think that but is that you want Ten of Cups, not Nine of Cups. So you might be very self-content. Like you are very emotionally, you might be feeling very self-content on your own. But you want to be with someone probably, and you want to have a family situation, or you want to be happy with your family. Virgos, there is a bad news. Your outcome card is the Five of Cups. So for meanwhile, you will be in a very disappointed stage. In the month of November, you might feel some disappointment because you hope for Ten of Cups, but your outcome is Five of Cups, which is resentment, grief, sorrow, sadness, loss. This loss can be due to a boss, someone that you're working with, or someone who is being very bossy. This can also be because of a authority figure who is probably saying something that you're not liking, and definitely authority figure, because we have two cards here now, the Hierophant and the Emperor. So you can be dealing with a Taurus or Capricorn as well. Sorry, Taurus, Capricorn, or Aries, or Leo, Sagittarius. So that's what I'm getting here. The Hierophant is telling me that there is someone who holds the key. So who is holding the key? I think there is someone in the authority, like a boss, someone who will probably hire you, or someone who is somebody else has the key to your problems, and they are probably deciding something which is against you. And I'm also getting that if you will follow your intuition, you will be in a better spot. So instead of listening to or giving your key of happiness into the hands of others, I think you need to ground yourself and listen to your soul even more, because all these cards are suggesting that you need to look for answers and your inspiration within. That's how you will have a wish fulfillment in a way. And there is a challenge, which is that you don't feel energized. You don't feel like things are in your hands, you don't feel like you can do anything, which is a very negative space to be in. I don't know why you are not trusting yourself enough. So you need to trust yourself, Virgo, and I'll pull out one more card. By the way, Virgo, your bottom of the deck is the Empress card, which is again a Taurus card. So someone is there who is quite abundant and they can offer you something. Like this person is very fertile, so probably the timing is right now fertile, or you're dealing with someone who can be very giving, basically. And this can be you as well, like someone who is looking for spiritual expansion as well, and someone who is trying to be abundant and self-sufficient. That is what I'm getting here. And but it is driving you insane. It is keeping you up at night because you're not able to decide, or you are not able to let go of something. And it's time that you drop this burden that you are feeling. This is the burden that you are carrying. You're thinking about something day and night, and you're working, exhausting yourself even. But what you need to do is that reach out to people who can be supportive, and just don't reach out to anybody. Reach out to a particular person who can actually really, really offer you something of worthwhile. Because I think you have been through some sort of a betrayal in the past, and things have come to an end in the past, and now you have to start something from the fresh, from very beginning. And here you are trying to plan for the further journey. And this can be also someone who is not making any moves, someone that you are dealing with, and this is you. This can be gossip, or this can be a group of friends who are actually trying to help you and trying to offer you support. But sometimes it's better that you become self-reliant and only ask for support when you feel that you know you are getting stronger because of that support, and not becoming dependent on that support. So I will pull out one more card from this deck. Defend to the end the worthwhile. So I'm feeling that you are quite knowledgeable. It's just that I don't think you feel that you I'm just feeling that you don't value yourself. This sentence may mean anything to you personally, defend to the end the worthwhile, but I'm getting that you may be very, very wise, but you're not valuing yourself enough, and you feel that it's not worth fighting for yourself. I'm getting prayer. So you need to definitely believe in the universe and yourself for some reason, and then joy. Some of you are also getting the word impartiality, so I don't know what that means to you, but impartiality is coming up. And the card at the bottom is what you want wants you. So it's basically like what you seek is seeking you. So in order to seek something, you need to have a perfect picture of it, and you need to believe that you can achieve it and you can do it. Otherwise it's no use, right? So I'll see you again, Virgo. I hope this reading helped you. In case it did, do drop me a comment. I'll truly appreciate it. See you.